Hi, my name is Sammy Zachary. I'm one of the Associate Program Directors for the Johns Hopkins Bayview Internal Medicine Residency Program. I wanted to spend a little bit of time talking about our program's different tracks that the residents go into, then focus a little bit about what residents end up doing after they graduate our program. After that, then I'll focus on the nuts and bolts of our program, talking about the inpatient rotation specifically, taking a look at what residents do on the wards, in the ICU setting, and elsewhere. So our program consists of residents in three different tracks. Most of our residents are either in the categorical or the general internal medicine track. Both of those tracks are similar. They're both three-year programs. Both of them have a continuity clinic, and they both meet the ABIM requirements for inpatient and outpatient time. The difference is the categorical track tends to have a little bit more elective time so that residents could pursue research opportunities or electives in their subspecialties of choice. For the general internal medicine track, that time is spent more on outpatient rotations. About a third of the second and third year is just devoted to outpatient time and continuity clinics. And so that's much more popular among residents who are interested in primary care or outpatient-based specialties. We also have a few of our interns in the preliminary tract. Most of these interns are go on to neurology, but we've had residents go on to other specialties as well. And these interns are essentially interchangeable with our categorical and general internal medicine interns. They are on the same rotations, they're treated just the same. And that's important because they're not cleanup hitters. They're not the ones who were required to do rotations that the categorical and GIM residents want to do. The only exception is that the preliminary interns, they don't do any continuity clinic because they're only here for 1 year. But otherwise, they're treated just the same. So after residency, our general internal medicine residents and our categorical residents go on to very cool fellowships and jobs. So about 80%, 90% of our categorical residents go on to subspecialties, ranging from cardiology, pulmonary, gastroenterology, to allergy, immunology, and geriatrics. And then many of our general internal medicine residents go on to fellowships as well, and those are mainly focused on outpatient specialties such as geriatrics or general internal medicine. The remaining 20% of our residents go on to very exciting jobs in academia or in private practice. Some take on jobs as public health officers, others work in policy, and others become leaders within primary care homes immediately after graduation. Now that we've talked a little bit about the categorical tracks and the GIM and preliminary tracks, and we also talked a little bit about what residents do afterwards, I wanted to focus a little bit of time on the nuts and bolts of our inpatient rotations. So our residents spent a lot of time on the wards. And so our ward rotation is basically the heart and soul of our residency program. It consists of two interns, one junior or senior resident, and then one night team person. So it's a four resident team. And then there's an attending who is also on this team, and they're responsible for all the patients on the team. We also, every ward team has a full complement of Johns Hopkins students, and these include usually two third-year students and one fourth-year, the sub-I. So it's a rather large team. All the attendings are Johns Hopkins University School of Medicine faculty. Many of them are either hospitalists or in primary care, or geriatrics, but a fair number of them are also in subspecialties such as infectious disease, rheumatology, etc. And there's a big teaching component to our residency program, and so you'll see teaching occurring both in a didactic setting in the morning, like in morning report, but you'll also see it on rounds. You'll see noon conference, and then there's also a chief's rounds where the team will round with our chief of medicine or the vice dean of education, just for additional learning opportunities. We have four inpatient teams, and each team has a specific focus. So I'm sure you've heard about the ILIKI initiative, and that's one of our teams. And this is focusing on patient-centered care. And being on ILIKI changes you. And I know there's other videos that talk about this, but ILIKI is what is the heart and soul of our residency program. It's who we are, and it really revitalizes the passion for medicine for our residents. And that effort on Aliki basically permeates our residency program and all the other rotations as well. In addition to our Aliki team, we have three other teams. And one focuses on diagnostic reasoning, and it's one of the focuses for our hospitalist group, which is one of the largest in the countries. And then the other two teams focus on physical exam skills and point of care ultrasound. So these teams each have a separate focus, but the general principles of teaching, education, having a supportive learning environment permeates in our entire residency program. I should note that the night team person on the team is a fully integrated person for each one of these teams. They will admit patients overnight, and then they'll present these patients in the morning for additional didactic and experiential learning. And then afterwards, they go home and sleep. So they're all integrated in the team. There's no night float system in our residency program. I want to shift gears a little bit and talk about our ICU structures at Johns Hopkins Bayview. A lot of people may not know this, but we actually developed the first multidisciplinary ICU in the world in the 1950s, and it was led by Peter Saffer and his colleagues. And because of that, we have a rich tradition of clinical care, research, and education in intensive care medicine. So we have two ICUs where our medicine residents rotate to. The first one's a medical intensive care unit, and the second one's a cardiac intensive care unit. Both are 12-bed units. They're staffed by three interns, three residents, one fellow, and one attending. And so it's a rather large team. And occasionally you'll have students who are doing their mandatory ICU rotation from Johns Hopkins, and also some physician assistant residents. This is one of the most highly rated rotations for our residents. And in fact, they're also one of the most highly rated rotations for the Johns Hopkins Hospital Osler residents, who also rotate in our ICUs and serve as second and third year residents. And the reason is because of we have great patient diversity and pathology. Patients are very sick here, and so you'll learn how to manage cardiac arrest, a large number of ST elevation myocardial infarctions, heart failure, arrhythmias, ARDS, pneumonias, all kinds of diseases that could affect our patients. Many of them have multi-organ system failure, and so it's a rich opportunity to learn from experts in critical care medicine and in cardiology. We also have a cardiology PCU service, and basically it's a cardiology service which focuses on patients with heart failure, acute coronary syndrome, arrhythmias, etc. And this is also staffed by a cardiology, Johns Hopkins cardiology fellow and attending, and then has two residents and two interns. So basically at our institution you'll get the full book of medicine. You'll see a lot of different pathologies in the inpatient settings, just because we have many patients who come to us from both the local community and around the world. And you also have that in the cardiology service and in the ICU setting. In addition to these inpatient rotations, you have access to all the resources for Johns Hopkins as an institution. So all our residents rotate at different hospitals in our system, including Johns Hopkins Hospital. And you will have the opportunity to rotate on like advanced services like lung transplant, renal transplant services, infectious disease, the HIV service, which is called PULC, hepatology, acute leukemia service, and anything else that might be of interest to you. So that's a little bit of a roundup of what we have here to offer for you. I mean, I just talked a little bit briefly about the different tracks within our residency program, what our residents do after graduation, and then talked a little bit about the particulars of our ward, ICU, and other inpatient rotations. Thank you.